Hi, my name's Frank Chodacki. I'm part of the IBM Cloud team. I'm here to explain some basic network concepts that are pretty ubiquitous or universally used, and the terms are NAT and Firewall. And let's start off with NAT. NAT stands for Network Address Translation. It's described in an IETF RFC 1918. And what NATing really does is allows us to translate internet addresses to private address space. And private address space is really there because there's only a finite number of internet TCP IP addresses. So to cover this topic, I always find it's better to use analogies, and we're going to use the apartment analogy to describe what an internal network or TCP IP range is versus an external TCP IP range. So over here we have our apartment buildings. We have apartment building one, we have apartment building two, okay? And within those apartments we have apartment buildings, we have apartment one, two, three, four, etc. And over in apartment building two, well, lo and behold, we have the same apartment numbers, okay? The only thing that really differentiates apartment one and building two and apartment one and building one is their street address. So much like an internet TCP IP address, the street address is uniquely addressable across the world, right? So we have apartment one is, let's say, 123 Street, First Street. And apartment two is 157 Second Street. Okay. So those addresses, the street address, is uniquely addressable across the world, whereas the apartments themselves, the apartment numbers, are not unique. So that really describes the difference between an internal 1918 TCP IP address and an external address. Well, how do you get between those two things? You get there by something called NAT, Network Address Translation. NAT is typically used to translate an IP address from one range or multiple IP addresses from one range to an IP address on some other range. It's commonly used between private internal networks and an internet IP address because those are finite. And subsequently, they can be very expensive to purchase or to use, right? So in the case of apartment one, we have a device that does our NATing. And the second part of this topic is firewalls. A NAT device typically goes along with a firewall function, and it's usually employed in some kind of a routing device. A routing device connects two or more computer networks. So we're just going to put our firewall down here in both our apartments here. So NAT, firewall. Okay, so let's say someone in apartment two wants to communicate or send a letter, a mail, remember those, mail, over to company1.net, and he wants to send it out over, you know, from his street address to the company one street address, or let's just say from his internal IP address to a public IP address or an internet IP address. What he would do is send that out to the NATing device, which is akin to, let's say you have a home router or routing device. That's the first device your traffic's going to hit. The NAT, network address translation part of that, is going to convert that internal address to a real internet address, which is what? It's this 123 First Street. That traffic is going to traverse from 123 First Street, so it's like sending a mail with the return address being 123 First Street, over to company1.net. As soon as company1.net sends a response, it's going to not send it to apartment 2. It's actually going to send it to 123 First Street. All right, it's going to send a response back. And what's going to happen is the NATing device actually keeps track of what's going out and the response, corresponding response. And it knows that the response to 123 First Street, let's say it's the person's name, they put their name on the letter going out, it knows it converts that to an internal address, which happens to be apartment two. It knows that person lives at apartment two. Here's the key. Company one doesn't know that that person lives at apartment 2. All it knows is 123 First Street, essentially obscuring the final address of that person. So by that, it's kind of a security device because it protects that person. It's akin to a security device. Now, that by itself is typically not enough. On the same device, we'll have a firewall function. What's a firewall function? A firewall function is known as a security device, service, appliance that actually monitors the network communication between some source and some destination, typically deployed across two different networks. That's not always the case, but in this analogy, we're going to just say the firewall is there between the internal network and the external network. And notice we have it deployed with our NAT device. So in a typical firewall, we'll have something called, the very first firewall is something called a stateless firewall. And all the stateless firewall is, it's just like a lock on the door. So if we put a lock over here, and we put a lock over here, all that says is, I'm a person that wishes to get into the apartment, I have a key, I'll open the door and go in. Well, it's not a bad way to go. It keeps most people out of the apartment building that don't live there, but somebody can tailgate. They can go in behind that traffic, maybe they figure out the key. There's a couple different ways. It's a decent firewall, but as things get more sophisticated, it's not enough. So the next type of firewall that came up was called Stateful. Love my writing. So a stateful firewall does this. Now we've hired a security guard, right? Here's our security guard. He's a cool dude. He's sitting at the front desk. So as traffic tries to enter the apartment building, maybe they have a key, he looks at the person and says, where are you going? I'm going to apartment four. Okay, so now that traffic's allowed to apartment 4. Doesn't ask what the person's doing there or anything else, just allows the traffic. So really, a stateful firewall will allow, understands the source and destination of the traffic, and it actually monitors the conversation between that source and destination, and does a little bit more being a traffic cop between those two source and destination. So last thing we're going to look at is something called an application firewall. And this is application. There you go. An application firewall is something that looks deeper at the conversation. So now we have our traffic cop over here, and what he's doing is now, rather than just asking what apartment you're going to, he's going to ask what your purpose is, right? So think of it this way. It actually looks deeper into the conversation. If we're talking about web service traffic, it makes sure that's really web type traffic that's being communicated from the source and destination, not just some other type of traffic that could meant to be, let's say, some kind of malicious traffic. So in other words, it's analogous to, okay, I have a person trying to get to apartment 2, and that person says that they're there to deliver a pizza when really, they're trying to do door-to-door sales. So the security cop or security guard in this case would figure that out and not allow the person to enter the apartment. And those are the basics of NATing and firewalling. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions, please drop us a line. If you would like to see more videos like this in the future, be sure to like and subscribe.